Let's go ahead on tidy things up around here. What's going on, Power Director peeps? Today, I'm going to show you how to get all those nasty little files together by managing your media library in Power Director 18. If your media is all over the place and you need to get it all cleaned up, I want you to put hashtag ManageMyMedia in the comment section below. Here we are on my beautiful desktop. Managing your media from the beginning of your project exponentially increases the chances of experiencing fewer issues with your media while editing your video, like missing assets from a project because you renamed or moved some of the files. So, in this video, I'm going to show you how to manage your media for best results using PowerDirector. Let's get that media in order. The first thing that you want to do is create a new folder for the project on your editing drive. So I'm going to go down to File Explorer, and I edit all of my videos on a SSD. So this is a drive here, so I'm going to left click on it. And then I'm going to right click in the folder area. I'm going to go to New. I'm going to go to Folder. And I'm going to name this folder Temporary. And I'm going to tap on Enter. Next thing you want to do is place some copies of files into the project folder that you created. Now, notice I said copies. We don't want to place the original files in there. We want to place copies in there because we want the originals to stay in their location. Now, my original files I keep on my Drobo. This is a drive that I have all of my assets on, my archive projects, stuff like that. So I'm going to left click on it. I'm going to go up here to Digital Juice. I'm going to go to Stock Footage. I'm going to go to HD. And we'll just grab the top three files here. I'm going to right click on them. And I'm going to choose Copy. I'm going to go back to the drive that I created the folder on. And I'm going to go into that folder. I'm going to right click and paste. Now, just to add a few more files, let's say we want some sounds in here. I'll go here. I'll grab this one. I will copy it again. Go back to the editing drive. Go back to the temporary folder and paste. So you can add all the files that you want. You'll be good to go. So we got our folder created. We got our assets in it. Now we want to go ahead and open up PowerDirector. Now, we want to make sure that the default folder for exporting is the same folder that we just created. This way, when you're saving your project, you're doing snapshots, you're rendering things, everything is going to go into the folder that you just created. That's important to make sure that you can continue to manage all of your assets and everything stays connected in the same folder while you're editing. So to do that, we're going to go to Preferences. We're going to go to File. And here you have your export folder. So we're going to click on Browse. And we're going to choose that same location and folder that we just created. And here the folder here, it's called Temporary. So you can double click on it or you can click on it and select OK. And now we see that our export folder is the folder that we just created. Now, remember, you're going to have to do this every time you do a project. This is some upfront management that you can do to make sure everything stays in sync and you really, really have control over your project, and you can always access all of the assets for the project that you're doing. So now that we selected the export folder, we're going to go ahead and click on OK. So now we want to go ahead and bring our media into PowerDirector. So the first thing I want to do is I'm going to right click on here in the media library, and I'm going to remove all unused content from the library. So all those sample files are gone now.
And now I want to go ahead and import the folder that we created with all of our assets, or the copies of the assets. So I'm going to right click on it and go to import a media folder. I'm going to select the temporary folder that we created and click on select folder. So now we have all of the assets that we copied over into that folder, and we can start editing and doing all of the beautiful things we want to do. So I'm just going to drag some files down here. Now, while you're editing and working on your project, you never want to move, delete, or rename any of the assets that you have in that folder. Because if you do, that's going to cause them not to work. They're going to be missing when you try to pull up your project. Don't move, delete, or rename anything in that folder while you are still editing. Now, if you want to add more files to your project, then what you want to do to make sure that everything stays connected is you want to add those files to the folder first and then import them into the project. So if we wanted to add more files, we would just go back to the location where we want to add them from. Copy it. Put it back into the temporary folder. And then we want to import it into the project, because we wanted to have that same connectivity to that folder that we originally created. And if you import the file directly in the Power Director by just dragging it in, or just doing file import without adding it to the folder first, it won't be kept in that working folder with all of the other project assets. Now, let's talk about saving your projects. But before we do that, I want to remind you to subscribe to Power Director University to see great tips and tricks just like this every Saturday. If you decide to subscribe, don't forget to click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. And don't forget to follow PDU Tutorials on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for even more Power Director love.
Now, let's get back to the breathtaking tutorial.
When it's time to save your project, you should always go to File, Save Project As. And when you do this, you want to create a new version of your project. So I'm going to go back to the folder, and I want to go ahead and call this one temporary one. And I'll do save. And then let's say I do some more editing. Who knows? And let's say I want to save it again. Then guess what I'm going to do? File. I'm going to do Save Project As again. And this time I might name it Temporary 2. And I want to click on save. Now, what this does is it helps us to maintain different iterations of the project. If something goes wrong with one of those projects, let's say I mess up something and I can't go back for some reason to the previous version, then I can go back to an old save, like version 2 or version 1, instead of having to start my project all over again from the beginning. So you always want to use File, Save Project As. If you just hit the save button, or if you do File, Save Project, it's going to save over your last saved version of the project. That's why you never want to use those options. Never use this little save project button. Never do File, Save. Always do File, Save As, and create a different version of your project so that you're not saving over the old versions. Now, once you produce your video and your project is complete and everything's good to go, and you know you're not going to make any more changes, then you want to archive your working folder or the temporary folder that I just created somewhere else for safekeeping on a different drive off of your editing drive to save space on that editing drive. Now, if you want to know how to archive your project, just click on the card that I'm going to have pop up in the video, and I have another video on archiving that you can watch to learn how to do that. Once you've archived your project, you can go ahead and delete the temporary folder. So I'm just going to do file new project here so that I can go ahead and delete it. Let's just pretend I've archived it. I'm good to go. Then I can go back to File Explorer. You can go back to my editing drive. And I can right click on this folder and I can delete it. And the reason why I can delete it now is because I've archived the contents of this folder. So when you archive something, and like I said, you can watch the other video to see how to do that. But when you archive and you pack your project, it's going to save everything in that folder. All the files you use, all the saves that you made, anything that you rendered and saved to that folder, everything will be archived in a separate folder wherever you want to place it. So it's safe to then delete all of this from the editing drive after you know that you're sure that you are done with the video and you've produced it and you're good to go. Now, following these steps is going to ensure that PowerDirector will always be able to open your project with all the files that you need for your project every single time. And that's how you manage your media for best results with PowerDirector 18. If you decide that you like PowerDirector 18 and you want to buy or upgrade to the software or purchase the 365 annual subscription, I'll leave some links in the video description. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.